Hello, Jan here. In this video I will explain how to create your own pre-made panels. First off, let me say that this is aimed for developers, so people using Air Manager to create their own instrument, or panels in this case. So if you are not used to doing that, I don't think this video is for you. Anyway, let's start going. What is a pre-made panel? Well, these are pre-made panels, so it's like a standard layout you can start with, so you don't have to create your layout from scratch and add each instrument individually. So what I'm gonna do in this video is I'm gonna create my own layout, so one that's not here but I think is cool and I want to share it with other Air Manager users. So in this video I can show you the process to get it going. So the first step would be to create a panel. I'll just slap something together a little bit smaller. I'm gonna add a couple of instruments to it. A clock, why not? And a call sign. So okay, this is my panel. I like it this way. Well, maybe not yet. I'm gonna give it like a background color. Yeah, perfect. Let's see if I start it. Yeah, this is my panel. Perfect. If I want to change the call sign, I know this is a user property of the call sign, so I can say, can set my own text. So let's set this to blah, and you see that it shows up as blah. This is important for one of the later steps, so that's why I'm doing it right here. I will explain in a bit. So now that we've got like our perfect layout here, we can create a pre-made panel out of that. For that we go to the Create Edit tab, and then instead of normal would be instruments, we go to panels. So this is where all the panels show up, also the ones you have downloaded before. In our case we're gonna create a new one. It will show up this panel information window, which contains all the metadata. Just it works the same way as the instruments do. So I'm just gonna fill some offer version 1, I feel confident, kind of aircraft, kind of cockpit, number of engines, which platforms this panel should support. I'm gonna go with the desktop systems for now. And we can fill in a description. So that's like the basic layers, like the panel itself. Now we can right click here, you can say add aircraft model, which is like the second layer. Here we tell you would tell it which aircraft model is supported by our panel. So in this case I'm just gonna go with the Beechcraft Baron. And you got an option here to you got two options, or you can go for a generic aircraft, which means that this panel is compatible with like all aircraft in X-Plane or FSX or whatever, or you can go for a specific aircraft model. In this case you still, okay, it's only for X-Plane and it's I only use this developer, maybe A2A, I don't know. Anyway, in this case we're gonna go with generic. So the next layer would be the layout. So in this case we have two options, or we can add a blank layout which has no instruments, you have to configure everything. Or you can go, which is easier I think, you can create a layout from one of the panels in Air Manager. So I just created the My Panel a couple of minutes ago, so let's use that. So here it is, My Panel. There's also a little bit of metadata for the panel itself, so the name it already copied. Position is the position in a complete cockpit. So in this case I think center would make most sense. The width and height already copied. The background color, which is green, which is just set up. This is perfect. And you can also like add another background image if you want to. You can customize this further if needed. You can also set a description for the layout. I will show where that shows up in the GUI in a bit. And note that it also copied all the instruments from the panel I created earlier. So the three instruments are here. Also the positions are taken care of. And an interesting thing is that for the Baron, the call sign, it also copied my user property. So in this case, this panel, once the user adds this panel, the user properties will be pre-configured. So let me show you that what it means if I create a second layout. So let's call this first layout first. Second one I will call second. So we have two layouts now. Let's differentiate a little bit. So instead of green, I'm gonna go with red. And I think the call sign should be second. And let's say the call sign of the first one to first would make sense. So now we have two different layouts, which contain the same instance, but they are a little bit different in the fact that they have different user properties and different background. So right now I think the metadata has been this should also be the center maybe. Metadata is okay right like this. So if you think you're done, you can click OK. You can always go back, by the way, to this screen. That's no problem. So select our new panel, which is created here. If you right click and then go to run, you can see it first gives the option for the different aircraft models. You can have multiple. In this case, we only have one, so that's easy. And then you can select which layout you want to start. So if I start first, you can see it has a green background, and the user property has been set in first, so the call sign will show first. And if I start the second one, you can see the call sign has been changed to second, which we just configured, and the background is red. One thing I should note, I think, is the preview image. It's if you go to the folder of the panel, the preview image should also be in the root, so preview.png, same as with instruments. And there are also preview images for the different layouts that you might have. For that you have to edit manually for now. I will probably fix that somewhere down the road. But anyway, create a folder, layouts, and then within the layouts you have to define the unique ID for that layout. You can find that here if you right click ID, copy to clipboard, create a new folder, and within this folder you can add the preview.png. So that's the way that works. So so I guess the panel is done right now. So just to show you how that would work for people actually using your panel. So go back to the first step, and we go back to the pre-made panels. And if we go down, yeah, here is our new panel. So there's no preview yet. So next, and here we can select the layout. So just to show you, I will, yeah, let's first, so this is the first layout, and then I will add another panel based on the second layout. So this, the first one I created at the start, and these two are based on the first and the second layout we just created. So the first one is green again, and the call sign has been set to first, and the second one is red, and the call sign has been set to second. So this is a very easy way for the user, at least, to have like different layouts for different applications. So yeah, you can, it's a very generic system, so you can go, you can do a lot of different things with this. But one thing that might help is like have one layout with all the screws and bezels enabled, and then have one layout without them. I'm just saying something, or different resolutions or stuff like that. There's no limitation there. There are two things I still want to point on quickly, and I think then I'm done. If you want to submit your panel to us, so if you want to share your panel with the rest of the Air Manager users, you can, same with instruments, is you can select your panel and then click submit and fill in your details here, and we will see if we can add it to our online store. So once that is done, it will show up in the first step for all Air Manager users. Yeah, another thing I wanna point out quickly is you can also You can also there's also a logic dot Lua for panels. You have access to, I think all API functions that are also available in the instrument logic dot Lua, and a couple of extra. And I'm going to show you one, which is most important, I think. So there's a function instrument get, and that that allows you to do to get an instrument from your panel. So let's, in the first layout, we're going to go, well, let's go with the call sign again, copy the ID. So we give it the ID of the instrument, and we will get an instrument ID back. It's like a pointer to that specific instrument, and we can do maybe we want to change the opacity. The details are described on the wiki, by the way. I'm just giving an example here. And if I run this, you can see it it made the call sign a little bit transparent. Maybe you want to change the visibility, it's also possible. So if I change visibility to false, it's gone completely. Yeah, that's about it, I think. If there are any questions, email me at koryan@siminnovations.com or post a question on the forums. That's about it. Thanks for watching.